process of making your decision?
It was stressful as, you know, at times, but it was also humbling. Just for me to be, you know, at that point that I can, you know, choose, you know, just to, you know, be loving myself or come back and just humble, you know. And it just I think it's pretty cool, you know. So.
Josh, what was the grade you got back from NFL teams? What did they tell you with your dad gone?
You know, it was just same thing I read. But there's a lot of things that I can work on, you know, that I can improve on a daily basis. And that's why I chose to come back to improve on those aspects.
What should Coach Stoops talk to you about what Bud Dupree did when he came back for his senior year at your position? And mm-hmm. obviously, it worked out really well for him.
Yeah, you know, I've been hearing that for quite some time now, you know. So, you know, as soon as I was, and about the, you know, the first round, or, you know, you're getting picked early, talking about, you know, Bud, then forget Bud, then, you know, so I take that in consideration. But I just didn't want to be like, oh, you know, Bud did it, so I can do, you know, I still want to, you know, play my, you know, do what I do. Like I said, we are two different players.
You kind of touched on it, but how was it humbling?
It was just because, like, once you read everything, you see first round, second round, like, you know, you've been thinking about this, you know, you've been thinking about it since you were young. Since we're children, you know, I grew up, we wanted to play the league, and it's just like, I can play, you know, like, so at that time, I was just like, oh, man, like, I'm here, but, you know, I always got to calm down, you know, I just had to breathe, you know, just relax and say, all right, Josh, you know, we just do what you do, you know, keep playing how you play, respect, you know, respect everybody you go against, respect your teammates, respect the coaches, you know, and time, your time will come, you know, and I feel like that's how it humbled me.
The things they wanted you to work on specifically that you're sort of keying in on for next season?
You know, main thing, you know, to get a little bigger, you know, but not everybody, you know, can be 250, 260, but I feel like I can, you know, gain a little bit more weight, you know, get a little bit more strong in the weight room, you know, and that's what I plan to do in this offseason.
Josh, being a dad now, what's that been like, and how much did you have to weigh that into your decision?
That was actually my biggest, you know, thought about, you know, leaving and coming back. You know, he just, you know, it changed everything, you know, once he came, you know, and that's another way it humbled me, you know. So, and now everything I do, you know, affects him now, you know, and I feel like just being here with him also, you know, affects, you know, my decision and all that. So, it's just, once he came, it changed everything. Made my thought process a little different.
How much can you improve with one more year in school?
I think I can prove a lot more. You know, I think I still have a lot to prove. You know, I feel like, you know, beginning of the season, I came off from a hot start, and towards the end, you know, I kind of slowed down a little bit. But I feel like next year, once I prove on my stamina, my strength, my speed, you know, all that, I feel like I can last more, I can play more. You know, be more healthier, come back stronger.
You're 12 sacks away from the school record. Is that a goal for you next season?
Yeah, you know, I actually talked to Elijah's dad, and I also talked to Elijah, and he told him that, you know, he did like a little video, and he sent it to me. He was like, you know, he won't mind Elijah, but, you know, he'll be good if me or Denzel breaks it, you know, I feel like, and I talked to him after that. You know, he just like, Josh, go do it. You know, I talked to Elijah, and Elijah talks to me the other day. He's like, you know, Josh, go do it. And so I want to go do it. You know, and I'm going to do everything I can to, you know, to get to that point. But we all know where it starts. We got to stop the run this year. So I can, and, you know, and all the other passions can go get them, you know, can get that money. So, you know, it starts by stopping the run. You know, think about getting 12.
What's kind of the ceiling for this defense now with you and Mike back and so many veterans?
Yeah, you know, leadership. You know, we can't just have two or three leaders on the defense. We gotta have multiple, you know, every position have a leader. You know, not just somebody who, you know, who does good in games. You know, we need senior leadership who's been there, who's been in the trenches, you know, who's been at Kentucky when they're bad. You know, who's going, you know, on a season like this. You know, I feel like we have that now with me, Mike, Denzel, you know, just Beatty, Ronnie, you know, I just feel like, you know, we're ready, we're not, well, I'm not saying we're ready, but we're preparing to be ready. You know, I feel like we're taking the right steps to do that.
How much did that help make your decision, just knowing so many guys are going to be back with experience this next year?
That, you know, not one person has to do it. You know, everybody wants to get it done now because it's our last time. You know, it's hard to say you won't wait till the last time to get it, but you got to get it now. You know, I feel like that played a lot, especially when Mike coming back and Denzel and Jordan, you know, and Lonnie and Chris and Beatty and Darius. You know, it's just all around the board, we're going to be solid. I just want to be a part of that.
Did you and Mike ever go back and forth to discuss what you were going to do together?
Yeah, you know, once I told him what I was going to do, you know, and once he told me he was going to do, he said, let's do it. You know what I mean? So we talked, me and Mike talked for, you know, a couple days prior, you know, for hours, you know, discussing about what can we do, you know, and like, you know, if we do leave, what will happen? If you come back, what will happen? And, you know, the good outweigh the bad.
Was it nice to have somebody to sort of bounce that stuff off of that was sort of in the same position you were?
You know, it certainly was because he knows what I'm going through. You know, he don't know, you know, about the baby, but like, you know, but other than that, the football aspects, he knows exactly what I was going through, and I knew what he was going through, and we got to talk, you know.
Did you have to make the decisions while, like, the sleepless nights with the newborn baby? I mean, was that part of it?
Yeah, you know, especially, you know, when people, you know, text and call me, like, so what you going to do now? What you going to do now? I just want to, you know, be with my son right now for a couple of days, and then, you know, once that, you know, start dwelling, I can, you know, focus back on football, I expect, you know. But I think, you know, just from him being here, you know, made the decision for me. You know, I couldn't leave him.
Josh, you talked about slowing down a little bit second half of the year. How much of that was physicality? How much was that of other teams that recognize this guy is becoming a really effective player on the edge and double teaming you, chipping you, things like that?
You know, that's another way, you know, just humbling. You know, like they actually noticing me. You know, other teams are game planning against me, you know, and it's just, once I think about that, it's like, man, so now I got to do things that, you know, to get better. You know, so now I know that they're chipping me, double teaming me, sliding my protection, you know. Now I know it ain't, you know, ain't possible, so now I know I can do it. You know, and I want to work on that in this off season, you know, so it's just an awesome feeling.
Was it frustrating at all when your numbers fell off and it was getting harder to get to the quarterback?
Yeah, but you know, I'm not a self player, I feel like I'm a team player, and as long as my team, you know, Josh Pascoe and Denzel started getting more sacks, you know. I wasn't like, man, why they getting all this stuff? You know, I was right there with them, you know, celebrating with them. So I feel like my time will come, you know, and their time will come, and their time was coming towards the end. And, you know, can't do nothing about that but respect it, you know, and be a good teammate, good brother to them, and support them.
What was Coach Stoops' reaction when you told him you were returning?
He just said, like, you know, just all the players he coached and all the players, you know, that came back, like Ed Reed, Bud, you know, and, you know, other players, you know, that came back, and he felt like it was the right decision. I felt like it was the right decision, and, you know, so I told him, like, you know, he's excited, like everybody else was, and I was just excited to be back and play for another year for the team.